Hello everyone, I am Reesha and this is For the Love of Classics. Welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be a book haul. I have accumulated so many books from my trip to Pakistan. I bought some of them myself. Some of these books were gifted to me by my family for my birthday, and I have accumulated enough of them to do a book haul. So without further ado, let's just start the video. So first I'm going to share the books I bought for myself. So I visited a number of bookshops in Pakistan. I visited London Bookshop in Peshawar. I found a great collection of Collins classics there and some great non-fiction, but I did not end up buying any books from there. The second bookshop which I visited was in Islamabad. If you are from Pakistan, you already know that Islamabad has some really good old bookshops. Many of them unfortunately have now closed down, but I did find a really good old bookshop in F7 Merkez, Islamabad. That bookshop was so amazing. I spent a lot of time browsing through that bookshop, but again, I did not end up buying anything from there. Even though it had an amazing collection of classics and I wanted to buy them all, I had some weight issues for my travel back to Dubai, so I could not buy all the books I wanted to. The next bookshop which I visited was Said Book Bank, also in Islamabad. It is one of the biggest bookshops there and I love going to that place. One of the guys working there was so helpful and he helped me in finding so many books I was looking for. So the first two books which I got are by a Pakistani writer, Babsi Sidwa. And I bought her books because Nashwa has praised her highly. I'm going to link Nashwa's video down below as well, in which she discusses all of Babsi Sidwa's works which she has read and the ones which she plans on reading. So the first one which I got is An American Brat by Babsi Sidwa. This edition is by Penguin House India. I love the cover of this book. It is so colorful and vibrant. Another publisher also publishes books by Babsi Sidwa. Those covers are very minimalistic and these ones are very vibrant. So I went for these editions by Penguin Random House. There were a lot of books by Babsi Sidwa and I just read the summaries on the back and picked two of the books which sounded fun to me. This book is 310 pages long. So for anyone who does not know, Babsi Sidwa is a Pakistani writer, but she lives in America. She has published a lot of books and her books have been translated into German, French, Italian and Russian. Let me share the blurb from the back. The extended family of Firoza Ginwala, a lively and temperamental 16-year-old girl, agonizes over the decision to send her to America for a holiday. This act of apparent audacity arises from concern over Firoza's conservative attitudes, which stem from Pakistan's rising tide of fundamentalism. Her relationships with the Americans she encounters and her many adventures shape her alternatively hilarious and terrifying perceptions of the USA. Meanwhile, Firoza's family in Pakistan is in delicious turmoil over the possibility that American ways will ruin her. This delightful coming-of-age novel is remarkably funny and an acute portrayal of America as seen through the eyes of a perceptive young immigrant. This edition also has the covers of her other books, which are, you know, published by Penguin, and they all look amazing. I couldn't find The Pakistani Bride and Ice Candy Man, otherwise I would have bought those as well. But this sounds super fun. I still have the receipt inside the book. Also smells good, smells of Pakistan. So this is the first book which I got and I hope Nashwa is proud of me. I got the book she recommended. The next book which I got is also by Babsi Sidwa and it is The Crow Eaters, another gorgeous cover. This book is 280 pages long. Faridun Jungalwala moves his family, pregnant wife, baby daughter and Jair Bano, his rotund mother-in-law, from his ancestral village tucked away in the forests of central India to seek his fortunes in cosmopolitan Lahore. But while Freddy prospers under British rule, life with the domineering Jair Bano is another matter entirely. In this wickedly comic and exuberant novel, Babsi Sidwa takes us into the heart of the Parsi community, portraying its varied customs and traits with contagious humor. Oh, another book I'm excited to read, and I know I promised many people that I'll be reading more books by Pakistani writers, so this is the first step I'm taking in that direction. I was also looking for books by Hasan Manto, but I couldn't find any of his books translated there. Bapsi Sidwa originally wrote these books in English. Hasan Manto wrote originally in Urdu, but his works have been translated into English. I dropped Milo all over me. By the way, this is my favorite drink. I love Milo so much. I can't find this liquid Milo anywhere in the UAE. I drank a lot of it while I was in Pakistan and I bought some with me as well, and this is the last one. So I'm going to enjoy it while I film. The next book which I bought is The Painter of Signs by R.K. Narayan. This is a classic by an Indian writer, and when I found this inside Bookbank, I immediately thought maybe I should, you know, buy something by this writer. So R.K. Narayan was born in South India. He was educated there. He passed away in the year 2001. Narayan's fiction earned him comparisons to the work of writers including Anton Chekhov, William Faulkner, O. Henry, and Flannery O'Connor. I have a book by William Faulkner and also a short story collection by Anton Chekhov, but I haven't been able to read them yet. This is not a translated work. It was originally written in the English language. For Raman, the sign painter, life is a familiar and satisfying routine. A man of simple, rational ways, he lives with his pious aunt and finds pleasure in his creative work. But all that changes when he meets Daisy. The name Daisy always reminds me of The Great Gatsby. A thrilling, independent young woman who wishes to bring birth control to the area. Ooh, it already sounds fun. Hired to create signs for her clinic, Raman finds himself smitten by a love he cannot understand, much less stop, and soon realizes that life isn't so routine anymore. So this is the third book which I got myself. The next two books are from my nieces. They asked me which books I wanted to get, and I told them about one of them and they got me two. The first book which they got me is Born a Crime by Trevor Noah. I really wanted to get this book because I have been told that it's a really good place to start with if I want to get into nonfiction. Nashwa suggested this book, and also because I absolutely think that Trevor Noah's personality is amazing. I did not even know about him before I got married, but my husband watches his show regularly and now I watch his show as well. I feel like he's really funny and smart. So Trevor Noah was born a crime. Not because he could answer back in 5 languages, not because his mother threw him out of the window of a moving car, not because he accidentally burnt down someone's house with a magnifying glass, not even because he took Hitler to a bar mitzvah, but because this was South Africa and his mother was black and his father was white. There's high praise for his book right on the back of it. Bill Gates has said that this book has moving stories that will leave you laughing. Everybody praises his book, and I love the cover of this book, Stories from a South African Childhood. It's an autobiography. It's written by Trevor Noah about his life. I usually don't read funny books, so I think it's going to be a different experience for me, but I have a feeling I'm going to enjoy this a lot. And it also has two bookmarks from Book Searcher. Okay, so Book Searcher is a new bookshop in Peshawar. It has a branch in Islamabad Jana supermarket, and it also has a branch in Peshawar on University Road. I have visited this shop in one of my vlogs, so I link it down below. I feel like I've been wanting to get this book for years. Whenever I enter a bookshop, it's right there. It was about time I got it. And when my sister called me and she asked me, which book do you want me to buy for you? I knew that this bookshop did not have a huge collection of classics, so I immediately said Born a Crime by Trevor Noah. I knew they would have this book for sure. So thank you, Rukaiya Noor, and thank you, Nabiha, and thank you, Maryam. The next book which they also got me is this one, 21 Lessons for the 21st Century. This book is written by Yuval Noah Harari from the author of Sapiens. I have seen many people read Sapiens. I'm not sure if this is book 2 I mean, should I read Sapiens first before I read this, or can I just, or is it a standalone book? Can I read it on its own? It says 21 Lessons is an exploration of what it means to be human in an age of bewilderment. We created myths to unite our species. We tamed nature to give us power. We are now redesigning life to fulfill our wildest dreams. But do we know ourselves anymore? Or will our inventions make us irrelevant? You guys know I am scared of nonfiction. We shall see. Have you read Sapiens? Do you think I should read Sapiens before I read this? Or can I read it on its own? Let me know, okay? So the next book which I got is a gift for my husband. He wanted to read this book. Fun story. My sister was asking me which book should she gift to her husband. And my brother-in-law is a businessman, and I suggested Shoe Dog by Phil Knight. So my brother-in-law started reading this, and I was telling this to my husband, and he said he wanted to read this book as well. So when we went to Pakistan, he said it would be really nice of me to gift him this book. And so I did. I thought he could read it and then I could read it as well. I'm going to remove the cover. I'm not sure why the books in Pakistan are covered in plastic. It's matte black. This is the story of the guy who started the brand Nike. I've heard it's a very motivational book. Fresh out of business school, Phil Knight borrowed $50 from his father and launched a company with one simple mission: import high quality, low cost running shoes from Japan. Selling the shoes from the boot of his Plymouth Valiant, Knight grossed $8,000 that first year, 1963. Today, Nike's annual sales top $30 billion, and its swoosh is more than a logo. The swoosh. But Knight, the man behind the swoosh, has always been a mystery. Now, in a memoir that's surprising, humble, unfiltered, funny, and beautifully crafted, he tells his story at last. He recalls the foundational relationships that formed the heart and soul of Nike, and how together they created a brand and a culture that changed everything. So I guess Vokas is going to read this first, and then we'll see what he thinks about it. Also smells so good. So this one is 386 pages long. Well, Bill Gates has read it and he says it's an amazing tale, it's real. So another nonfiction. Wow, what's happening, people? So the next three books which I got, I think I've already showed in my vlogs, but I want to share them in this book haul video as well. The first one is New Grub Street by George Gissing. I love The Odd Women by George Gissing, and I bought this book from Kinokuniya in one of their clearance sale. I got it at a great price. It's a Penguin English Library edition. It's one of the old rubbery ones which have the picture of the author on the inside. It's a long book. It is 570 pages long. An irresistible tale of ambitious hacks and struggling writers, New Grub Street is set in a twilight world of shabby Victorian London garrets. Amid the low-end publishers and cheap bookshops of Grub Street, the novelist Edwin Reardon is battling to make a living. While his friend Jasper, a striving young reporter, writes anything the market demands, Edwin's determination to maintain his artistic integrity means that his life, career, and marriage soon reaches crisis. Also smells good. It's a bit brown around the edges. I'm not sure if you can see it. I love these editions, and I'm so glad I have another one of these in my collection. The next book which I got is also by George Gissing, and it is The Whirlpool. This is in the Penguin Black Classics edition. It's 480 pages long. George Gissing was a Victorian writer, so I bought them thinking I'll read them for Victober. Harvey Rolfe is a confirmed bachelor until he meets the fascinating musician Alma. Restless, ambitious, dissatisfied. Through the story of their doomed marriage, one of jealousy, faithlessness, and financial disaster, The Whirlpool creates an unforgettable picture of the maelstrom of late Victorian London as its cast of characters cling desperately to their respectable world of gentlemen's clubs and private incomes, terrified it will be swept away. Written in the shadow of George Gissing's own unhappy domestic life, his astonishing 1897 novel encapsulates the glamour and darkness of the end of a century. George Gissing wrote towards the end of the Victorian era. That's why his books explore themes which are quite different from the Victorian writers who wrote during the earlier years of the Victorian era. The Odd Women is sort of feminist fiction, so his books definitely look at the Victorian era from a different lens. The next book which I got is also by a Pakistani writer, Mohsin Hamid. I have been calling him Mohsin Hamid for 4 or 5 years now, and I just realized that it is H-A-M-I-D, which is not Hamid, but it's Hamid. So I apologize. And nobody corrected me in the comments as well. I guess you guys didn't notice. I got his book, Discontent and Its Civilizations, Dispatches from Lahore, New York and London. This is his collection of essays, which he has written about various topics. As a Pakistani who spent his childhood in the United States and his adult life in London, Hamid has a unique perspective on the civilization clash which has defined this era. These elegantly crafted essays confront everything from the future of Pakistan and the death of Osama bin Laden to fatherhood and falling in love. So the essays are about life, about art, about politics. I love the minimal cover of this edition as well. There was another edition of the same book in Pakistan, but they have a different cover there. I guess this is the second Pakistani writer's book which I managed to buy. And the last book which I would like to show you guys is the one I got almost a year back, but I forgot to bring it with me and I never even showed it on my channel. So I'm going to include it in this book haul. It's also a gift from my sister-in-law and it is Reclaim Your Heart by Yasmin Mujahid. There has been a lot of praise for this book as well. It's nonfiction. It's a motivational book. I'm excited to read this, especially now. I have a lot of anxiety and I feel like this is going to help me. Many of us live our lives entrapped by the same repeated patterns of heartbreak and disappointment. Often we have no idea why this happens. Reclaim Your Heart is about freeing the heart from this slavery. It is about the journey in and out of life's most deceptive traps. This book was written to awaken the heart and provide a new perspective on love, loss, happiness, and pain. A manual of sorts, Reclaim Your Heart will teach readers how to live in this life without allowing life to own you. It is a manual of how to protect your most prized possession, the heart. And my sister-in-law also left a note for me. It says, Dearest Reesha, as they say, books are the best companion and I know you love to read. I could not think of a better birthday present for you. This book is really close to my heart. I hope you will like it as much as I do. From Hania. Thank you so much, Hania. I finally bought this book with me so I could read it. I'm really looking forward to reading it and it's not even that long. It's just 180 pages long. So these are all the books I got. I bought a few of them myself. I was gifted some by my family. I wanted to buy so many other books because the books in Pakistan are pretty cheap and they are very expensive here in Dubai. So I wanted to buy many others, but I could not bring them all with me. But I'm really excited about these books and let me know down in the comments if you have read any of these books. Have you ever heard about these writers? Do you plan to check them out in the future? I am so thankful for all the kind comments you guys left on my previous videos wishing me for my birthday. Thank you so much, everyone. I love reading your comments, so keep them coming. And I'm going to see you all in my next video very, very soon, inshallah. Bye.